Hello and welcome to this Facebook Live on Banega Swast India. We've all been talking about physical health when it comes to COVID-19, but a lot is not being said about mental health, how it's affecting our mental well-being. To talk about how to cope with mental health, improve our mental well-being, we have with us Brahma Kumari, Sister Shivani, who's joining us, who'll be helping us to understand how to deal with the situation. Thank you so much, Brahma Kumari ji, for joining us, and Om Shanti.
Om Shanti ji.
You know, the first thing, like what I said, we're talking about physical health. In a tough situation like these unprecedented times, how can we really help, or, you know, what can we do for our emotional health?
Yeah. See, one thing we need to understand is what is emotional health. Emotional health means our coping skills with situations. So even if we look at our emotional health before COVID, if we believed that stress, anxiety, anger, worry, fear was natural, then we were not in the best emotional health even before COVID. And then came a situation where we allowed our mind to say that fear and anxiety is normal. You know, so we can't label uncomfortable emotions as normal. It's like calling an illness normal. Stress, anger, anxiety is not normal, is even visible on the body. That when we create any of these emotions, even the body starts showing signs like you know, the pulse, the heartbeat, hands sweating, or you having nausea, acidity, which means these emotions are not normal. So most important thing is to identify emotional health issues. So even if I don't have a mental health issue, but I need to take care of emotional health so that I never tip off to a mental health issue. And so emotional health means shifting from blaming people and situations for how we are feeling, because it's not the truth, and taking responsibility of every thought, word, behavior, because we are the creators of our thoughts and emotions. We can't say that just because the situation is difficult, so those emotions are normal. So taking responsibility and then few simple steps by which we can nourish our emotional health.
So I think first, what you're trying to say, ki pehle hamein identify karna kya problem hai, and then we can work on it.
Yes.
अगर हम पूछे कि ये मेंटल एक्सपर्ट्स आजकल काफी रिपोर्ट्स आ रहे हैं दैट वी हैव सीन एन इंक्रीज इन एंजाइटी अक्रॉस एज ग्रुप्स इन द पास्ट वन मंथ यू नो एक्चुअली थ्रू द पैंडेमिक इट्स ऑफन डिफिकल्ट टू कीप काम यू नो लॉकडाउन क्वारंटीन सेल्फ आइसोलेशन सो मेंटल स्ट्रेस से हम कैसे डील करें
मेंटल स्ट्रेस नहीं होता है सिचुएशन सी स्ट्रेस का सिंपल फॉर्मूला है स्ट्रेस इज इक्वल टू प्रेशर डिवाइडेड बाय रेजिलियंस. So we need to get the equation right. It's pressure divided by resilience. Pressure badha hua hai. So pressure is situations. So pressure could be an exam for a child. Pressure could be a traffic jam. Pressure can be COVID. Pressure can be that I am going through the disease. Pressure can be the toughest situation that I've lost someone. So pressure, which means what is happening to me in my life is pressure. But stress is not equal to pressure. Stress is pressure divided by resilience. So resilience means inner power. So that denominator is different for everybody. So all that we need to do is we need to start building up the denominator. We can't just keep blaming the numerator. Build up the denominator, because that's where the power lies. The denominator is in our hands. The denominator is not in the situation. So if we take up simple steps like early morning, nourishing the mind with pure positive content, studying spirituality or anything positive that we like. Don't begin the day with learning and hearing about the world. You don't absorb the world on your mind in the first 30 minutes of the morning. Suppose you wake up at 4, 5, 6. You don't absorb the world there on your mind, not even work communication, at least for 30 minutes. This mind is like a blotting paper. Absorb it with pure content first thing in the morning. The first hour of the morning is extremely important for building that denominator. So nourish the mind with pure content, that's spirituality or a positive book or a self-transformational book, whatever each individual chooses. Then few minutes of meditation or self-reflection. So at least 30 to 40 minutes for taking care of the mind, the self-care time, taking care of the mind on a daily basis, and at least 15 to 20 minutes before going to sleep. Same thing. Because these are the two times which have a deep impact on emotional health. Just when you wake up and just before going to sleep. And during the day, start practicing that people and situations don't create my emotions. I am the creator. So even if we take a simple thing like anger, okay, leave aside stress and fear right now. because now is not the time to work on it. Take simple thing like anger. That's nothing to do with COVID, right? Mm-hmm. So I'm getting angry only because people are not behaving my way or work is not getting done. Just start taking care in those situations that I'm not going to react to the situation. I'm going to handle it with ease and dignity. Just if we do that much, we're conserving emotional health.
Yeah.
We're conserving this energy here. And if we start conserving this energy, this emotional health will start getting better. Fear will start reducing. Anxiety will start reducing. So take care to nourish in the morning and in the night, and take care of the practical application during the day.
So I think making our own self stronger, apne bahut achhi tarah explain kiya. We've got a first question. Anjali Kumar is asking, Sister Shivani, my husband has recovered but still very weak and gets tired. The last few weeks have been very challenging and stressful for me and my family. How can I work on myself to be easy and calm in my mind? Thank you.
First and foremost, let's take the vocabulary. We need to change the vocabulary. Now, this is a very common thing we will say. The last few weeks are very stressful because it was challenging times. Mm. Challenge and stress has no connection. People can get stressed even if there is no crisis in their life. So don't equate the two things. Huh? Last few weeks have been challenging. Let's put it there. Yes, there was COVID in the family. Husband is still not feeling fine. She must have managed everything on her own. Lot of things. That is challenging situations. Now even the challenge is over because he's fine. Now I need to understand that because my mind, which was not being nurtured and energized on a daily basis, was facing a challenge every single day. It's like you're working hard without eating well. So how long will the body handle? It will collapse one day. They're like, I don't have any more strength left. Same is happening with the mind. So just introduce this simple practice from today, 30 minutes in the morning, and please request your husband also to do it. Mm-hmm. He also needs to do it. You also need to do it. And if you have children at home, they also need to do it. So at least 30 minutes in the morning, start with meditation, together study spirituality, practice yoga, pranayama, you know, keep that self-care time. Mm-hmm. We thought we'd have to do nothing to take care of the mind. Actually, that's the thing. We thought we don't have to do anything. The mind is supposed to react on its own, respond on its own. So that mind is now giving us signs. It's like running a marathon without training on a daily basis.
Mm-hmm.
It will start giving signs. So similarly, take care 30 minutes in the morning, 15 minutes in the night. Itna karna hai, bas itna hi karna hai abhi thode din ke liye. 30 minutes in the morning, 15 minutes in the night. We do not use phones and TVs first 30 minutes in the morning and last 15, 20 minutes in the night. Please take care. It's not for consuming the world onto the mind. It's for consuming healthy content in the morning and in the night.
So it's very important what content you're actually consuming. I hope until
early morning and late night. Yes.
Yes, so it's very important. In fact, Gagandeep Barad is asking, and I'm quite inquisitive. It's an interesting question. I have teenage kids with no school routine. They're not being able to meet their friends. There's a lot of anxiety and they're kind of depressed. Please guide me how to help them to deal with it. I think as mothers, we all are worried, you know, the routine isn't there. So what to do? How are the kids dealing with it?
Okay. Situations are different and everyone has the coping skills to face a situation which is different. These are times which are actually making the children stronger, emotionally stronger, because these are life skills in practical, not life skills in theory or as a subject. So it's actually going to build up the inner resilience of a child, because imagine not going out, not meeting friends, taking care of everything at home, helping mummy and papa in the garden or in the kitchen. Very different times. They've never done it before. And maybe if this situation would have not come, they wouldn't have done it also. So these situations are actually making them stronger. The only thing we need to take care is that parents are not creating anxiety. What impacts children is also the anxiety of the parent. If the parent is calm and stable, the child is taken care of. So these basic emotional health skills, which we as adults will do, we involve children in that. Even if they can't do it for 30 minutes, they can do it for 5, 10 minutes. That early in the morning, hum subah subah kuch achha padhenge, phir hum yoga pranayam karenge, hum 5 minutes silence mein baithenge. Just let the mind and body sit still. And if parents and children do it together, the child will start doing it. Very important. Then simple things like don't have meals with phone and TV. It's very important. यू नो दिव काइंड ऑफ मेड अ संस्कार दैट खाना खाना है तो टीवी तो साथ में चाहिए ही, फोन तो चाहिए. नो, डिस्ट्रैक्टेड ईटिंग. डिस्ट्रैक्टेड ईटिंग इज नॉट गुड फॉर द बॉडी, इट्स नॉट गुड फॉर द माइंड ईदर. सो माइंडफुल ईटिंग प्रैक्टिस फॉर चिल्ड्रन एंड फॉर अडल्ट, माइंडफुल ईटिंग प्रैक्टिस. सो लेट्स मेक अ कल्चर एट होम, नो फोन एंड टीवी वाइल ईटिंग. सिंपल कल्चर बन गया. देन जस्ट बिफोर ईटिंग वी टेक अ 5 second पॉज, कनेक्ट टू गॉड, से यार थैंक यू, एंड देन एनर्जाइज द फूड विद सम वेरी पावरफुल थॉट्स लाइक आई एम पावरफुल, आई एम काम एंड स्टेबल, आई एम परफेक्ट एंड हेल्दी. We call these positive affirmations. So energize your food and water with positive affirmations because we are what we eat. So if the food and water is energized, because right now the food and water of the city also has fear and anxiety. There's so much fear and anxiety in the air. So we need to remove the emotional infection also, not just wash off things for the physical infection. We also need to remove the emotional infection. So just pause for 5 seconds. Say those positive affirmations in your food and water. Eat mindfully. Even that has a deep impact on the mind. And cooking. The food needs to be cooked in a very high energy vibration. So the kitchen at home should have high energy words playing throughout the day, especially during these times. You know, like we cook in a temple or any place of worship, Gurdwara, Masjid. Similarly, kitchen at home, have high energy words playing. Prayers, hymns, chanting, bhajan, जो भी हमें अच्छा लगता है रसोई में चलते रहना चाहिए. It should go on playing in the kitchen. It energizes the environment of the kitchen and it energizes everything that is being cooked. This is not a small thing. It has a deep impact on the mind and on the body. This is how we cook prashad and make amrit, no? This is how it happens. We need to do it throughout the day, all the meals for the family.
तो बहुत सिंपल टिप्स है लेकिन दे कैन मेक अ ह्यूज इंपैक्ट. इनफैक्ट सानिया डोगरा पूछ रहे हैं सिस्टर शिवानी, वी आर सराउंडेड बाय अनसर्टेनिटी इन एवरी एस्पेक्ट एंड यू नो देयर इज लॉट ऑफ नेगेटिव न्यूज, सोशल मीडिया आल्सो कॉजेस एंजाइटी इन एवरी फैमिली नाउडेज बैटलिंग कोविड. देयर इज अनसर्टेनिटी विद द लॉकडाउन बीइंग एक्सटेंडेड, डू आई अंडरस्टैंड इट्स इंपॉर्टेंट बट इट्स ओवरवेलमिंग. एज अ यूथ हाउ कैन आई कीप काम एंड बिलीव दैट अ ब्राइटर फ्यूचर इज पॉसिबल फॉर possible. I'm also looking for a value creating job and finding one right now amidst the pandemic seems impossible.
Sabse important cheez, we should know the impact of content on our mind. We are what we watch, read, listen. Ye hame equation pakka kar lena hai. What we watch, read, listen is who we become. So we need to take a lot of care. If the content I consume has ego, lust, jealousy, violence, greed, corruption, if I keep absorbing that, I will start becoming that. And that's a lot of content that we are absorbing through all platforms. Through all platforms. So we need to remember an equation. Content is equal to personality, is equal to destiny. Now choose your content. Content will create personality. Personality will create my destiny. So I need to choose carefully. If I absorb pure content, I will start creating a powerful personality. If I start consuming so much of this negative content, I will start creating a negative personality. It is just a simple equation. So it's basically taking care of the emotional diet. So content is emotional diet. So we just can't keep scrolling like this and say, oh, this was just time pass. It's not time pass, it's toxic. So be very careful what we are absorbing from all the platforms. So restrict content consumption. You know how we take care of our physical diet? We really need to take care of emotional diet. All of us, and especially children, restrict content consumption from OTT platforms, from your social media handles, from everything.
Yeah.
Every word that we are watching, reading, listening, we are becoming.
हमें काफी सवाल आ रहे हैं. इनफैक्ट हमने देखा है सुषमानी की डॉक्टर्स और हेल्थ केयर वर्कर्स ने बहुत काम किया पैंडेमिक में, यू नो दे रियली कम फॉरवर्ड. एक डॉक्टर पूछ रहे हैं, डॉक्टर अभिनव अग्रवाल, कि डॉक्टर्स आर फेसिंग अ लॉट ऑफ स्ट्रेस, अ लॉट मोर देन यूजुअल एंड हैव लॉन्ग वर्किंग आवर्स इन डिफिकल्ट सर्कमस्टांसेस. एनी एडवाइस
डॉक्टर्स के लिए?
डॉक्टर अभिनव अग्रवाल,
डॉक्टर्स के लिए तो अभी सेवा और थोड़ा चलेगी लंबे. इट्स नॉट रियली ओवर येट, इवन दो थिंग्स आर क्वाइट सेटल्ड. सो इट्स वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर देम टू नरिश देयर माइंड ऑन अ डेली बेसिस. तो जो हम आधा घंटा कर रहे हैं, अगर उनके पास आधा घंटा नहीं है, इवन वाइल दे आर ट्रैवलिंग, दे नीड टू कंज्यूम हेल्दी कॉन्टेंट फॉर द माइंड. चूज वॉट यू आर गोइंग टू कंज्यूम टू नाइट एंड टुमारो मॉर्निंग, डेफिनेट. सेकेंड, रोज रात को सोने से पहले they need to release what has happened during the day. You see, they are recording a lot on the mind during the day. They are used to facing crisis and death, but it's like once in a while. Yeah. Here, they are seeing so much of it happening in a one single day. So they are consuming a lot and it is getting recorded on the mind. So just before going to sleep, we need to release all that. And which means just reflect, meditate, maybe write it out. It's good to have a daily journal. You know, write out what happened during the day and just surrender it to the higher power. I tried my best. My conscience is clear that I put in my best karma. The rest is destiny of the soul. You know, doctors can treat, they can heal, but they cannot write the destiny of people. So they should not take so much baggage on themselves. Their conscience has to be clear that we've done the right thing. So when something goes well and a patient recovers and they give you so much appreciation and love, surrender it. Thank you so much. It was their destiny. I was only an instrument in it, and they are cured. Thank you. So you have to surrender the appreciation. And then when something doesn't go right, we have to surrender that also. That we did our best, but we need to clean and surrender in the night before sleeping so that we clean the mind, heal our mind, don't carry any baggage, and then go to sleep.
It's a post-COVID symptom, kehlo, ya neend nahi aati, kisi ke hospital mein bahut din rahe the, memories bahut hai, ward ke, and obviously lack of sleep leads to many other issues. So usko hum kaise handle kare, kaise koi soch sakta hai better apne sleeping habits, or ultimately hamare lifestyle pe bhi sleep ka asar padta hai.
Yeah. So sleeping habits otherwise also and sleeping habits after COVID also. 2 hours before sleeping, we need to disconnect from work communication. 2 hours before sleeping, we need to disconnect from work communication. See, the mind is in the beta place, beta stage or beta plus stage during the day, which means thinking a lot. And when we sleep, we go from beta to alpha to theta to delta. And delta is deep sleep. But if I'm thinking a lot before sleeping, many of us are not able to go to the alpha stage or to the delta stage. That's why we're saying neend nahi aa rahi. Even we all experience na ke jab koi man pe problem ho to neend nahi aati. To hum sochte hi ja rahe hain because the mind is in the beta stage. So 2 hours before we sleep, we need to disconnect from work communication. As if we don't have phones, we don't have laptops. We need to go back to that era that we are at home from work and now there is nothing. So 2 hours we start disconnecting. 1 hour before we sleep, we disconnect from all other media, which means don't consume anything, any media which is stimulating the mind 1 hour before we sleep. It's very important. It's going to take you in the beta plus stage otherwise. So 1 hour before you disconnect from any other media which stimulates you, then you start, even especially for those who have just come out of COVID and are having issues, you start dimming your lights of the room 1 hour, 1.5 hours before sleeping. So your body starts creating the melatonin, which is needed for the body, you know, for the brain. So start creating that. Have very soft, specifically meditation music created for sleeping. So if you just go online, you will find that music. Music for sleeping. It has a deep effect on the left and the right, both brain and the slowing down of the thoughts. So start playing that music and then do something like reading a positive book, or, you know, writing, doing something that is going to start bringing you into the alpha stage. If you're talking to family, don't talk anything which is a problem discussion. Don't argue. So again, don't take your mind into the beta stage. So just take care of those little things and we can create a few affirmations. Just keep saying them. Just close your eyes and keep saying them so that you're saying positive energy thoughts like, I am a powerful being. I am calm and stable. I am fearless. The past is over. You know, we have to tell the mind, the past is over. I am safe. I am secure. I am healthy. I am at home. I need to keep recording this new information on the mind, and God's power and blessings is a circle of protection around me. Keep saying it like your personal prayer and keep saying it and saying it and saying it and close your eyes and you will find your mind slowing down. And that's when the brain and body will be able to sleep. The mind has to slow down. It's not about the brain and body not being able to sleep. It's the mind has to slow down.
So these affirmations make a huge impact.
Yeah, because overall, you're consciously creating a positive thought.
Okay. So So just a last question, it's about loneliness. At this point, everybody is facing, and loneliness has a huge connection with depression. And because of COVID, isolation, quarantine, going back to the same thing. Again, is there a connect here?
See, loneliness and being alone are two different things. So when I am in quarantine, I'm alone, but I need not be lonely. If I have decided my routine properly, how my morning is going to begin, how I'm going to engage myself during the day, I do video calls with people, I remain connected. If I am feeling better, I can do online programs. I can do everything. I am alone for 14 days or 20 days, but I'm not lonely. And sometimes I can be amidst people, but I am very lonely. I'm very lonely. Lonely is about how I'm feeling inside. It's not about how many people are around me. That's alone. So if that is how we are feeling, then we need to work on why am I feeling like this? Why do I not feel connected to people? What is it? Is it about people? Is it about me? Why am I not feeling connected to people? Why am I not feeling nice being with people? And most important, just do this little thing of nourishing your mind with positivity daily. You just have to energize the mind. The weakness of the mind will go away. It's like increasing the emotional immunity. Automatically, you'll be able to fight the challenges of your life. So start doing that and restrict the other content and consciously make it a part to connect with people. We used to connect with people when we went to work. Now, because we're not going and we're not going for social gatherings. So then make conscious connections. Make it a point to call up people. And one thing that makes a difference is a video call. A video call is very different than just talking on the phone. So if you make a video call, you have a more person-to-person connect, and that make you feel better also.
I think you've answered a lot of questions. In fact, we have a lot of questions. If there's something, we may get back to you and you can reply them. Just before we go and before we wrap up, ek aakhri sawal main aapse puchna chahungi. Aapne bahut achhi tarah sara samjhaya hai emotional health ke bare. Kuch tip aap dena chahenge ki इस मुश्किल टाइम में जैसे आपने समझाया है जरूर लेकिन हम कैसे स्ट्रॉन्ग रह सकते हैं और अपने इमोशनल हेल्थ को और बेहतर कर सकते हैं अगर आप हिंदी में ये हमें समझा सके.
जैसे हम अपनी फिजिकल इम्यूनिटी को बढ़ाते हैं जैसे ही हमें कोविड के बारे में पता चला हमने अपनी फिजिकल इम्यूनिटी पे काम किया ना क्योंकि हमें पता था कि वायरस से बचने के लिए इम्यूनिटी को बढ़ाना है अर्थात हमारे शरीर के अंदर शक्ति है उस चीज से अपना ध्यान रखने की बचाने की अगर वो हमारी बॉडी में आ जाता है तो भी उसको खत्म करने की वी हैव ऑल द पावर विद इन वी ओनली हैड टू बिल्ड अप उसको हमें बढ़ाना था तो हमने सही खाना खाया सही एक्सरसाइज की अच्छा सोए हमारी इम्यूनिटी बढ़ने लगी. सेम चीज मन के लिए भी करनी है. मन की भी एक इम्यूनिटी है कि बातें आती हैं परिस्थितियां आती हैं लोग अलग अलग तरह व्यवहार करते हैं मन की इम्यूनिटी अर्थात हम उस परिस्थिति का सामना कैसे करते हैं. कोई बहुत जल्दी हताश हो जाते हैं कोई बड़ी से बड़ी परिस्थिति में भी बहुत स्थिर रहते हैं तो दोनों की इम्यूनिटी अलग अलग है ना उसी परिस्थिति के अंदर. तो उसके लिए हम रोज अपने लिए समय निकालें कि सुबह दिन की शुरुआत सबसे पहले उठते ही हमारा मन बिल्कुल साफ है स्वच्छ है स्थिर है तो सुबह सुबह उस पर बहुत सात्विक बातें डालें बहुत शुद्ध बातें डालें ध्यान करें मेडिटेशन करें और फिर आध्यात्म स्पिरिचुअलिटी अर्थात प्योर कंटेंट शुद्ध बातें परमात्मा का ज्ञान उसको यहाँ सुबह सुबह भरें. वो आपकी शक्ति को बढ़ाता है वो मन की खुराक है जैसे शरीर के लिए खुराक अच्छी लेनी है मन के लिए भी खुराक अच्छी लेनी है. फिर सारा दिन के अंदर ध्यान रखें कि आप सारी दुनिया की जो बातें हैं सारी चीजें जो आप देख रहे हैं उसकी क्वालिटी क्या है. अगर उसके अंदर काम क्रोध लोभ मोह अहंकार ईर्ष्या नफरत ऐसी बातें होंगी तो आपके मन की खुराक क्या वो सही है. और अगर ऐसी खुराक लेंगे तो मन कमजोर नहीं होगा. तो थोड़ा सा ध्यान रखें कितना लेना है और क्या लेना है इसका पर ध्यान रखें. और फिर रात को सोने से कम 15 मिनट सोने से पहले फिर कुछ बहुत शुद्ध प्योर बातें अपने मन पर भरें परमात्मा को याद करते हुए अच्छा सोचते सोचते अगर सो जाएंगे तो बड़ी गहरी नींद आएगी और मन का इम्यूनिटी सिस्टम बढ़ जाता है.
थैंक यू सो मच ओम शांति आपने बहुत अच्छी शेयर की हमारे साथ बहुत एजुकेटेड एंड आई होप वी कैन ऑल इंबाइब दिस इन आवर लाइफ. थैंक यू सो मच ओम शांति.
थैंक यू जी थैंक यू.